guys. Give me 50 kilometers per hour on the clock. Thank you. And do remember to be cautious with the Constantina effect into turn one. Green light, green light, green light. And they're all pulling out here as it's a drag race down the front straightaway. Muhammad already losing some positions here. Is he three wide as they go down? I don't think is anyone going to survive. John Green losing multiple positions here. Yeah, don't say that on comms. What is going on? Did they just make it through there? I am surprised. Kadeem Muhammad with the lead of this race now, and we're looking back, they're still surviving. What is going? No, sorry, we lost Mornay Duploy, and it seems like Garth Edie and Javon Edie, sorry, Javon Edie and Garth Huey, but now Kadeem Muhammad's got the race ahead of him, of his life, I should say. On the inside, Christian Rajnott, Khalil Rickford. And he's going to get the benefit of that taken out. Who was that? It's Harrison and Christian Rajnott. Now Khalil goes up into third position. John Green falling down all the way back into fifth position now. And let's look back on the field. Top of the field, Kadeem Muhammad has wrestled this Mazda RX-7 into first position. But Oswin Wilson is keeping him sincere. Kadeem going into the bush almost right there. And looking back, John Green does see Joshua Brady ahead of him. And even closes Stephen Pummels to Raul Pratap. Oh, is he going to come in contact? Almost. Look back up. Joshua Brady is being passed by John Green. And on the break in they go. Joshua on the inside. They switch back. John Green does go ahead into fourth position now, and he sees Khalil Rickford getting all shifty there in the middle of the gooseneck. But he gets going again. Where's Oswin Wilson? Some 7/10 away, and they're pulling away from Khalil Rickford. Joshua Brady keeping it close though to John Green as he's deep on the brakes here into turn two. Oswin Wilson seemingly closing that gap to Kadeem Muhammad as they are beginning to spread out now. Oh, Kadeem Muhammad runs it wide. Oswin Wilson takes that fight to him. It's a drag race down. I told him, watch that bump. Look at how high that RX-7 went. He lets him go by though as he's on the outs inside there, and it's very bad to take that turn into the gooseneck there on the inside. And he knows he's got a lot more laps to go. And he's pressuring the Bajan here now. Let's ride with him. Look at how close he gets to Kadeem Muhammad. He can almost taste that exhaust fumes as it comes off of that RX-7. On the inside, he sets that up nicely. Oswin Wilson. Can he make it complete? No. Kadeem comes back. And this is the point where I lose my voice. Oh. On the inside now. Can he get it done? No, he backs out of it once again. And while they're fighting, Khalil is going to close that gap. Oswin seemingly playing with the Bajan now as he's that close out of the gooseneck. Rob Pratap is going to make a move against Michael McName in the meanwhile, and Michael McName seemingly dropping down the order. Stephen Pummels now takes that position. He loses it back though, Stephen. No! He's going to lock it up, Oswin Wilson, and he's going to go into the bush. Bushman that. Rickford and John Green are going to come across him. And while they had to pause for the yellow flags, Khalil Rickford is going to lose some time here now to John Green. Khalil Muhammad is going to retake the lead of this race. Oswin cannot get out of the bush there, and he's going to be out of this race. Khalil has got John Green now to worry about in the slipstream. And look at them jump over the bumps there now into the gooseneck. They go. Khalil, he's gotta let that go. John is gone. And John from 8th position, I think, or 6th position, he's now up into 2nd. Meanwhile, Kadeem has got a great lead now after winning. Oh, he's got to be careful not to make the same mistake as Oswin Wilson. And Khalil is going to be very, very close now to a John Green. John is going to run that really wide, and he's going to get in contact with a wall. I don't think he can get out of there. Oh, he's got to take it back into the pit lane. And that's it for John Green. Robert Thomas is going to go up into 3rd position. Stephen Pummels as well is going to go up. Jaden Harrison, they're all going to come across John Green because he's out of this one. What a race that was. It had come down to Kadeem Muhammad. He's seemingly going to win this one as long as he can hold on. They're already on lap 8. Khalil Rickford is going to claim 2nd position. And Rob Pratab as well. Ooh, we got Stephen Pummels coming out of the gooseneck all out of shape. And now he's lost 2 positions there to Jaden Harrison and Michael McName.
Blue front, sir.
John Green still in pit lane there. Garth Huey, DNF, Mornay Duploy out of this one as well. Christian Rajnott all the way back into 9th position. Javon Edey in 8th. Oswin Wilson did rejoin this race here, but he's all the way back in 7th now. Can Khalil Rickford close this gap? I don't think so. They've completed 8 laps. They're on the 9th one here. But Kadeem is in a commanding lead here over the Guyanese. 3.5 seconds to the region. As we look around the field here now, Oswin Wilson does see Stephen Pummels, but can Stephen hold on? I think he can. As the leader is now on the final lap of this race, Oswin is going to run it wide and lose some more time there now to Stephen. Kadeem Muhammad on the final lap of this race, the Bajan winning the most competitive classification here at South Dakota on the most demanding of tracks. I should say layout, that is. And he's actually opening the gap to Khalil Rickford, or Khalil is just losing pace here. But this is how it's going to end. Kadeem Muhammad is going to come across the line here now with his first win here at CSRO. Congratulations to him. Khalil Rickford is going to claim that 2nd position comeback kid here. And then Rob Pratab doing quite well here in this class. He's usually known to be a class down, but he comes in on the podium. Jaden Harrison is going to claim that 4th position, and Michael McName is going to bring up that top 5. What a race this was, I'll tell you what. That was pretty good for me, man. I enjoyed that one. And Javon Edie will be the final person to come across the line. Is he? No, John Green is going to have a DNF, though, because of that one. And that's going to be it. All right, Kadeem, you can go back into the pit lane, as well as Kalelric Firth and Rob Pertab. All of you guys can go back into the pit lane, actually. Oh, I think you guys wanted to do a drag race down the back. I'm not sure if the server will allow that in terms of time, but you guys are free to do it. But it's Kadeem Muhammad here. Who's going to take the win home for the top classification here. And I think the rest of the guys are at the back doing a drag race. Yes, we will have this drag race, drag layout ready for some drag race events. Yes, drag racing events are possible in the sim. You know what happened there, right? All right. Let me get myself in a good position here. How about I look down the front straight away? Or just a look in general at the Great South Dakota Circuit. With this current set of layouts that we have. Alright guys, good run. That was fascinating. Well, not fascinating, but very much exciting to watch. Rob Pertab holding on there to claim that third position. Congratulations to you, bro. And you know, you just had to paddle, and soon enough you will get there. This is the top classification as we would rate it, by the way, and you've managed to be on the podium. Congrats to you.
Thank you.
And tell us, go ahead and tell us how that race was for you.
It was pretty fun, I'm not gonna lie. It's as close as IRL when I race, so I was pretty excited, honestly, to race on this track, especially the endurance layout. But yeah, fun race.
Alright, happy to hear that. And most definitely, Raul Patab is, if you guys didn't know, is a competitor here at GMRNSC. Thanks a lot there, Rob Pertab. As we go on to Kalelric Firth, Kalel, it doesn't seem as though this entire night was good enough for you. We know we're usually accustomed to seeing you on the top steps, usually all the way at the top. But tell us, how was the track for you in general, and how was the event?
Well, this was just a fun event, so I wasn't taking it super seriously to, you know, be fighting at the front and wanting victory. But the track's okay. I mean, I got the problems that gotta be fixed, hopefully can be fixed. But yeah, that was the first time I ever drove the enduro track. Can't believe people drive that in real life. That's crazy.
Yep.
Yeah, and yeah, overall it's decent.
Alright, good. Well, thanks a lot there, Kalelric Firth. And now we move on to Kadeem Muhammad. I don't think we've seen you here since the Amzile event, is that correct?
Yeah.
And now you've been able to claim the top spot here, but maybe you'll have to come back because Khalil said he wasn't really racing you. Yeah, but great win by you there, Kadeem Muhammad. And it's your first time in a top classification. But again, like the guys are saying here, they just did this race for fun. So maybe you got to prove your point in some future races. But talk us through that one for you.
Well, first couple laps I struggled because I don't really like this car, honestly. But I got the grips with it a little, and I was a little fortunate too because I would probably been passed by Ozzy, but he crashed. So. Kept me in the lead.
Yes, and Oswin was keeping you honest throughout the entire race. Unfortunately, we did see him go, you know, into the bushes. John Green as well, losing that one into the bushes. But thanks a lot there, Kadeem. All right, so if you guys want to stick around, we're going to talk a bit about South Dakota Circuit and where we plan to take it in the future here. Just give me a few seconds. Hear it when I try.
Oh, there.